Students, this is chemistry class 64B. Now we are going to discuss the trends in electroporation with respect to the electro system, M3 plus M2 plus system. We have already discussed the M2 plus system. Now let us take the M3 plus M2 plus system, electrode system. So this system, electrode system, arises according to the equation, that is M2 plus use ratio M3 plus plus 1 electron. So that is the electrode system M3 plus M2 plus system arises due to the according to the equilibrium M2 plus use ratio M3 plus plus 1 electron. What about the SRP values? SRP, standard reduction potential values. The standard reduction potential values depends upon the arrangement of electrons. Arrangement of electrons in M3 plus M2 plus system, and generally the SRP values increases in the d-block elements or any series of d-block elements from left to right. You see, increases from left to right in the series, because from left to right in the series generally oxidation property increases and the reducing property will be decreases. That is the reason why the SRP values so increases from left to right. So due to the increase in the oxidation property and decrease in the your reducing property, of course. So that means, you see, in order to explain the variation of electrode potential for M3 plus M2 plus system, it will depend only on the arrangement of electrons in M3 plus and M2 plus. Let us take some of the examples. How actually the variation will take place? So first example I am going to take is scandium. Scandium has low SRP value. SRP value for that is Sc3 plus Sc2 plus system. That is, scandium has low SRP value for Sc3 plus Sc2 plus. We know that scandium atomic number is 21. For Sc, that is 21 atomic number. For Sc3 plus, we have the electronic configuration argon, that is 3d0 4s0. 3d0 4s0. What it means? For scandium 2 plus ion, we have argon electronic configuration, that is a stable electron configuration. P0 is in the electron, that is a p orbital. No electrons are present, and 4s electron. So that is actually scandium is argon 3d1 4s2. But here 2 plus 3 electrons have to be removed. Other than that, so you will get argon 3d0 4s2. So therefore, it is very easy to remove one electron from Sc2 plus to convert to Sc3 plus by removing one electron. That means it is very easy to remove one electron from Sc2 plus to convert Sc3 plus, which is stable. Sc3 plus is stable, you see, due to the argon configuration. So therefore, it is very easy to remove one electron from Sc2 plus to convert to Sc3 plus. So therefore, there is no SRP value for Sc3 plus and Sc2 plus. This is the first example. Let me take another example, you see. Second example. So that is, let me take the zinc, you see. Zinc has a high SRP value, for xenon-3 plus xenon-2 plus system. Why? Because we know that atomic number of zinc is 30, we know that, so atomic number 30. But xenon-2 plus is nothing but zinc, so this is a compound 3d10 4s0, d10 4s0, where it has got, it is completely filled, completely filled, stable electron. So therefore, it is not easy to remove one electron from the xenon-2 plus, because it is already stable electron configuration. So then to convert Sn2 plus to get xenon-2 plus to get xenon-3 plus xenon-3 plus one electron, it is very difficult to remove this electron from xenon-2 plus to convert xenon-2 plus. For this reason, it has high SRP value for xenon-2 plus. magnetic field B completely linear and stable. So therefore you see it is very difficult to know only electron from zero to plus or convert current difference. Therefore zero has a ESR field like that. Okay, so that is second. Take another example also. So let me take the example of your manganese. So this manganese also has high ESR periodic power. Mn2+ system. Actually, here you see, if you take manganese, it has there is Mn2+ or Mn2+. It has the configuration of carbon Pt5 equal to 0. So generally, off field and complete field atoms are more stable. You see, that is exactly off field, more stable. You see, So therefore, it is very difficult to remove one electron from Mn2+ to convert into Mn3+ one electron. So since it is stable, it is very difficult to remove one electron from Mn2+ to convert into Mn3+. Therefore, Mn has also high, that is your SR field, standard reaction potential. So this is the third example. Take one more example for iron. You see, we know that the iron. So iron, you see, so generally iron, if you take iron, has low SRP value for Fe3+, Fe2+. Why? How often you see iron has a 26, as you know, that is Fe3+. If you go for Fe3+, so then you get the argon, that is 3d5 4s 0. Argon 3d5 4s 0. So that is 26. In the 26 means you see 3d6 4s 2. So 18 plus 2, 20 plus 6 26, that is iron. But now Fe3+ means argon 3d5 4s 0. That means it is also off field. It is off field. Off field. So therefore, but it is very easy since it is stable electron configuration. But it is easy to convert Fe2+ to Fe3+. Fe3+ just by removing one electron. It is stable. But it is stable. You see, it is not stable. Therefore, it is very easy to remove one electron from Fe2+ to convert Fe3+, which is more stable. You see, so for this reason, higher natural SR value for Fe3+ and Fe2+ is done. So that is how you can explain the SR values for the 3+2+ system. That is M3+M2+ system. So that is the one more example you can take. You see, lithium has low SRP value for V3+V2+ system is radium, scandium, radium. So this you see, you can have, that is V2+ radium. V2+ has the electron configuration, you see, argon, that is 3d3 configuration, you see, 3d3 4s 0. 3d3 means, you see, it has only 3 electrons in 3 orbitals. Other 2 valence orbitals are there according to this electron configuration. So therefore, you see, it is very easy to convert V2+ to convert into V3+ by using one electron. It is very easy to remove one electron from V2+ to convert into V3+. So for this reason, radium has a also low SRP value for the system V3+ and what? V2+. So this is how we can explain the trends in electron potential for Fe+ Fe2+ system. Okay. Again, let me take one more concept in that is 3D series or is transition element. You see, so that is trends in the melting point of transition metals, transition series or transition metals, transition metals. So trends in the melting point of transition metals. Generally, melting point of transition metals, remember, melting point of transition metals is mainly depends upon the involvement of n minus 120 orbitals, n minus 120 orbitals, orbitals in addition to ns orbitals, ns electron orbitals. So that means the melting point of transition metals exactly depends upon the involvement of n minus 120 orbitals in addition to the ns orbital. In addition to what? Ns orbital or ns electron. So generally, melting point will be raised to the maximum extent where in that is defect configuration. In transition metals, generally the melting point will be raised to the maximum at the defect configuration. Defect configuration generally, and that is melting point increases from left to right, from left to right in the series, and there we have the defect configuration. It is highest melting point we have. So, but exceptions are also there in this case. You see, for there is manganese and technetium, tellurium, sorry, manganese and tellurium, due to the anomalous properties. So, there is change in the melting points for manganese and tellurium. Okay. So, this is trends in melting point of transition metal. That means transition metals melting point depends upon the involvement of the electrons of n minus 120 orbitals in addition to the ns orbitals electrons. And the melting point will be maximum, rises to the maximum only under the configuration of defect configuration, not the defect configuration. And there is an exception for manganese and tellurium, where due to the anomalous properties or anomalous values for manganese and tellurium, so there is some difference there. So after that, trends in melting point, let me make one more concept for transition element. See, so density for transition metals, density for transition metals. Generally, you know, density is mass by volume, you know. But here, generally, the density of transition metals, so rises or increases from left to right. If you go for left to right, the density also increases. The density increases in each and every series of transition metals from left to right, and it is due to the fact that as the atomic number increases from left to right, as the atomic number increases, scandium to zinc, of course, like as the atomic number increases, atomic radius decreases. You see, as the atomic number increases, the atomic radius increases. Why? It is due to the increase in the effective nuclear force. As the atomic number increases, atomic radius or atomic volume. As the atomic number increases, atomic radius decreases due to the increase in the effective nuclear force. Atomic radius will decrease or volume will increase. That means you see, atomic radius decreases as the atomic number increases due to increase in the effective nuclear force, the effective nuclear charge. So therefore, density also increases. Why? Because according to the equation, density is equal to mass by volume. Mass by volume. That is, density increases due to the increase in the charge and decrease in the volume. Atomic radius increases. So that is, the effective nuclear charge will go up increases. Therefore, density also what? Increases. That is how we can explain that in the density for transition metals. So that completes the concept with respect to density, variation in the trends, the trends in the electrode potential with respect to M2 plus M and M3 plus M2 plus system, electrode system, and also the trends in the melting point of transition metals. What we will meet in the next video.